Hi, my name is Lance. I'm a design engineer here in Geberit. This is my colleague, Miranda. We are the design team here in Australia. So ProPlanner is a software that Geberit developed that can be used to design and optimize the pluvial siphonic roof drainage system. It can be used to produce isometric drawings, hydraulic calculations, and material lists.
Today, we're going to use a simple project example to show you how to use Geberit ProPlanner to size a siphonic roof drainage system. As you can see, we've got a simple project example set up over here where we have seven outlets, with each outlet receiving a flow rate of 9 litres per second. We're dropping here 7 metres on the left before our discharge point. This will be the project that we're going to size today. Now that I've done that, I can go into ProPlanner, so I'll just open that up now. So now that we've opened ProPlanner, we're greeted with this interface, so we can click on the Roof Drainage Systems module to enter our siphonic design. So I'll just click on that now. And now we can enter details for our project number. So for this one, I'm just going to call it P1234. And our project name we'll call Example Project. We can also enter in information for our street. So for this one, I'll just call it Example Street. And then our postcode and our city as well. After we've done that, we can also enter our personal details for our plumber / sanitary engineer data. So I'll just put my name in here. After we've done that, we can click finish. Now that we're into the ProPlanner interface, we can actually start drawing pipe sections. So I'm just going to click draw pipe here. Now I'm going to move outside this drawing frame to give me a little bit more space to work in. And then I can enter in my first pipe section. Now, the main thing to note here is that when you're drawing pipe in ProPlanner, it's in the isometric view. So you can draw in the X direction, the Y direction, or the Z direction. And if you're ever unsure in which direction you're drawing, you can just refer to the direction box here on the left. Now, what I want to do is draw in a horizontal pipe section for our main collector pipe. So I'll just put that in now. And after I've done that, I can introduce my 45 degree offset. Now, to draw offsets in ProPlanner, there are a couple different ways to do it. You can click on this button over here to draw in the XY plane. And you can click on this one here to draw in the XZ plane. And this one allows you to draw in the YZ plane. Now, what I want to do is draw in the XY plane, so I'm going to click this one here. After I've done that, I can insert my 45 degree pipe offset, and then we can go straight down to draw a downpipe. After I've done that, I can put in a transfer point to define where the system ends. So I'm just going to put in set transfer point over here, and then insert that at the bottom of the downpipe. Now, after we've drawn in our main collector pipe and down pipe, we can insert our branches for our outlets. So again, I'm going to click draw pipe over here. And then we can put in our branches like so. Now, we need 7 branches for our 7 outlets, so we can draw them out all individually, or I can just hit Ctrl C to copy, and then Ctrl V to paste it across. And we need to do that 7 times for each of our outlets. Okay, and another thing that you'll note is that when I'm drawing, I'm not trying to draw to scale, and the reason for that is because we want to make the labels as clear as possible. After we've drawn in our branches, we can insert our tailpipes for our outlets. So again, we click on draw pipe up here, and then we just draw in a short vertical section like so. And then again, we hit Ctrl C to copy, and then Ctrl V to paste that across. So we've put in our tailpipes, and now we can actually insert our outlets. So to do that, we need to click set roof outlet up here, and then we can put that in 7 times for each of our outlets. Now that we've drawn the main system layout, we can actually start inserting our pipe lengths. So to do that, what we need to do is double click on the labels, and then we can insert the lengths as they were in the previous drawing. So the downpipe, if you remember from before, that was 7 meters long. So I'll double click on that and change that to 7. And then similarly for all these pipe sections, this one was 1.65 and this one was 1.8. And now that I've done that, I can insert the lengths of my branches, which were all 1 meter long. So again, while holding control, we'll select all these labels. And then we'll double click and change that length to 1 meter. And then similarly for each of our spacings between the outlets, those were 6.55 meters. So we can select all our labels again. You'll notice that as we change these pipe sections, they get highlighted green. And what this is saying is that whenever you change a pipe section, ProPlanner will highlight them green. And this just lets you know that you've already updated it. Okay, and we also need to insert our lengths for our tailpipes. So for this example, I'm going to use 0.25 as the length. So again, while holding control, we'll select each of these tailpipes. Then we'll change that to 0.25. Now, similarly for our outlets, we'll select them all. And then we'll change the length of the outlet spigot to 0.25 as well. And while we're here, we can also insert our target volumetric flow rate for our outlets. So again, if you remember from the example, that was 9 liters per second. So we'll just change that to 9 and hit OK. Now that we've drawn up the main system layout, we can actually begin optimizing the sizing of the system. To do that, what we need to do is click Optimize Diameters up here. But you'll notice that after we click Optimize, these triangles pop up in the system. And what these triangles represent are the reducers. And if these come up, it means your system is working correctly. Now, I'll just demonstrate what happens if we've made a mistake in the drawing. So let's say we forgot to connect this pipe section correctly. And if we hit optimize, we'll get this red highlighting, which shows that we've made a mistake somewhere. So again, we can view where we've made this mistake by going into the message list. So I'll just click there and we can see that it says the object is not completely connected. Now, if we click on this, it'll take us straight to where we've made that mistake and we can fix it up. So I'll just fix it up by connecting that there and then we can click optimize diameters again. After we click optimize diameters, we can fix the diameters to prevent them from changing each time we change something else in the system. So I'll just do that now. And then after we've done that, we can hit recalculate up here. Now, if we wanted to change one of the pipe diameters, we can do that pretty easily. So I'll just double click this here and then we can change that to 160. And after we've done that, we can recalculate the system by just clicking here. Now that we've changed that pipe diameter, let's say we're happy with the system now and we want to print a schematic out of it. So the first thing we need to do is adjust the drawing frame. So we'll click on that up here. And what that does is it repositions our isometric so that it's within the drawing frame. Now, if we want to add text to the schematic, we can do that as well by just clicking this button up here. So insert text, and let's just say this one's our primary system, so I'll label that as primary. And then we can also change how it looks. I'll make it bold and increase the text size. And we can also add in a border and put in some colors. And on top of that, we can also add in a legend, which just makes things a little bit clearer. So we can toggle the legends by clicking on this here. And then we can move that inside the drawing frame. And now if we want to get a material list out of this isometric, we can also do that pretty easily by just clicking up here. And then we can alter what we want to produce. So right now it's on hydraulic list and that just gives you all the calculations for the system. But say we wanted a material list, we can just uncheck hydraulic list and then check cover sheet and material list. And that will just list out all the components used in the system. And if we want to get a schematic out of this, we can click on this button up here. And that just produces a nice clean schematic of the drawing frame. And we can save that to wherever we want. So as you can see, ProPlanner is a pretty simple way to produce a design for a siphonic roof drainage system, as well as get out a material list and a schematic. And if you have any questions, feel free to contact us.